All right, welcome into Money Tuesday here on Good Day Alabama. Stuart Welch with the Welch Group joins us, and we're talking about different tax implications from the sale of property. And Stuart, I know one of the questions you had was about a state property tax exemption for senior citizens, which I didn't know about until I read this. But explain the criteria for being eligible for that.
So almost nobody knows it, so it's kind of surprising. But if you're 65 or older on your homestead, the house you live in, you can actually apply for and get a state of Alabama property tax exemption.
Okay.
Now, depending on what your income is, it may be a full exemption or it may be a partial exemption, but very few people know about that.
Yeah, I didn't know about it. Now, okay, let's say you're 70 years old, okay? So for the last 5 years, you didn't know about it. Can it be retroactive? Can you get some money back?
A lot of people are surprised about that they've left this money on the table, and the question is, can I go back and apply for those years that I missed? The answer is no.
Oh, darn it.
And the place to go is to call your local county property tax assessor, and they'll give you a form. That form actually has to be completed every year, so it's a little bit of a pain, but it's worth, can be worth several hundred dollars.
Right. Now, I know you had another question about a guy who got an inheritance, a large amount of money, and they were wondering if they should put it in an offshore account or maybe put it in a traditional IRA in terms of tax implications. Which is better?
So let me set this up, Mike. This person inherited $800,000,
okay,
and they were in their 50s. They are in their 50s, and as they describe themselves, kind of a middle-income type person. And they said, should I take this $800,000 that I'm going to get and put it in an offshore account in order to avoid fees and taxes, or alternatively, should I just roll it straight into an IRA? And the answer is no and no. The first thing is if you inherit money from an estate, by the time you get your check, that check is not going to be subject to any taxes or fees.
Okay.
And so there's no need for an offshore trust, which is really complex and can be very expensive to set up. And alternatively, that money cannot be rolled over into an IRA.
Okay.
So what I would recommend is that they take the money, go to a discount broker like a Charles Schwab or a Vanguard,
okay,
open up a personal account and begin to invest there. This person had some experience in investing, and they can just use their own strategies.
And then also make friends with me. That'd be great.
That would be good.
All right, thanks, Stuart Welch. Appreciate it so much. We'll be right back. More Good Day. Stick around.